one of my little Seramas laid this egg. I brought them inside because it was so hot. And I heard them sing their little egg song that they sing after they lay an egg. I don't know if you've ever heard that before, but they make like this little clucking song after they lay an egg, and you go in there and there's an egg. But anyway, either Raven or Goldie laid this egg, and I didn't think that they were laying it, but apparently they are, and I'm going to start looking a little bit more thoroughly in their coop to make sure I'm not missing any of their eggs in the sawdust. I use pine shavings for bedding, and sometimes I can't see the eggs and they kind of get buried underneath the shavings. But anyway, I've got these two little ladies inside for today, and they're serenading me with their little egg songs. Last night was miserable. It got to about 107 degrees during the day, and then it never got lower than 94 degrees overnight. If you can imagine what it's like all night long for it to be in the 90s with no breeze, and I had the air conditioner going almost all night long. I finally turned it off towards dawn. I was like up and down all night long watching YouTube and trying to get some sleep. It was miserable. I'd have the fan on, and then I'd come in here and sit in front of the air conditioner because I don't have an air conditioner in my bedroom. But I was just miserable. I had driven into the city during the day, and I was really worried about the animals. The heat was just horrible, and a couple of the hens, when I got back, they were prostrate, and I had to give them some electrolytes with an eyedropper. They're okay today, but I'm, you know, really being careful with them today, making sure they get plenty of shade, and I'm doing the brick and water thing in their little coops to make sure that they stay cool. But yeah, it's been pretty miserable, and there's no end in sight to this heat. This heat wave is, I guess, across the U.S. Everywhere it's been really hot. I think the coolest place in the U.S. was Trinidad, California, and that was 53 degrees the other day, and I kept thinking, I would so love to be there. I love it there, and just to hear how cool it was, and just to imagine being by the ocean and the cool redwood forest. If anyone out there wants a visitor, lives out there, I'd love to come and visit you in Trinidad. If I can never get away from my animals. Anyway, I'm going to bring the two birds out here so you can see them. Okay, so this one is, the black one is Raven, and the gold one is Goldie. I haven't played with these guys for a while. They've been in the coop with the rooster and the other hens, but I decided to bring them in so I could photograph them and just, you know, kind of so they could take it easy in the cool house since it was so hot yesterday. Hildred, quiet. But anyway, they're really tiny little hens. And I'm so excited that they, well, one of them started laying. I'm not sure which one. They're about 12 ounces each. See how tiny they are. Little Raven has very big black eyes, and Goldie has a bit smaller eyes. She's got a slightly different shape wattles and both have really nice combs. They should make some really cute little chicks. So I will be selling their eggs as well, selling and shipping, because these guys are about 18 months old. I didn't think because they were so tiny that they were lame, but apparently they are, and I've been collecting their eggs, and I actually thought that they were the crosses that were laying the eggs, but apparently it's these girls. So I don't know if you can see them down here. I'll hold them up. So I'm always amazed at these tiny little eggs, how a little baby could be inside there growing. And then, you know, when they hatch, it's amazing. Especially when you've got a little broody hen sitting on them. The Seramas are very good little mothers. They're always going broody. I wish they wouldn't go broody so much. So here's Goldie and Raven. I wanted you to get a good look at them. See how cute they are. I'm just keeping them in here today because it's so hot. They're really adorable little chickens. Maybe you can see how small they are compared to my hand. They're about the size of my, even smaller than my hand. Sorry for my dog barking. Another tough thing about this warm weather is the bugs. The mosquitoes last night ate me up alive. I've got like several really bad ones, and I hope they're not getting infected, but they're like, I don't know if you do this, but I get really swollen whenever I get a mosquito bite, and it's almost like there's fluid in there, and it lasts for almost a week. So I've got mosquito bites all over my arms, on my legs, even on my knees. So I'm trying to think of some way of getting rid of the mosquitoes. I don't have a lot of standing water, but I'm sure there's standing water somewhere around here with all the rain that we've been having. And DEET just does not work for me. Any kind of insect repellent I've tried, like off or anything like that, just does not seem to work for me. So I was wondering if anybody had any suggestions about insect repellents that I could use. I know there's some like little bracelets that you can get. They're like coil bracelets, but they didn't look like they would work. Maybe they do. I don't know. Let me know. You know, shoot me a comment and let me know what you found that works, because I just really don't want any more mosquito bites. I've already got all these marks all over my arms. It's embarrassing, you know, because they get really big. And the flies too. I've got, you know, all those bags full of pennies hanging. I don't know, maybe it's the chickens, maybe that's the reason I've got so many flies, or maybe it's just the climate now, you know, during the rainy season, the monsoon season, we have a lot of flies. I don't know, this is my first monsoon season, so I don't really know what's typical, but there are a ton of bugs. I found these black bugs, flying bugs around the garbage can last night. I don't know what they were. They're less than half an inch, and they're really black, and they have wings. But since I was just using it on the garbage can, I got some insecticide and sprayed it out there. It was well away from the house or the animals or anything. I can't have insecticide with the birds, so I use diatomaceous earth. But there just seems to be so many different kinds of insects here that I've never seen before. They're all, you know, crawling, flying things and spiders. Not as many spiders as these, I guess they're water bugs. They're even like these iridescent green things that fly. Yeah, I'm miserable. Yeah, I could use going to the ocean or someplace like that. Just someplace different. I just need to get away, but I feel kind of trapped in a way. I know I shouldn't be saying that, but I do feel kind of trapped right now. And it's so hot. And there doesn't seem to be any end in sight for this weather. God, I wish it would cool down. I wish that September would come really fast. All right, I hope we don't have an extended monsoon season or anything like that, because I'm not really able to do much of anything. I'm just like hanging out inside in front of the air conditioner and doing stuff on the computer. And I'd like to get some stuff done around the house, but I'm just not able to. It's miserably hot. So anyway, I hope it's cooler where you are. Stay tuned and we'll see you next video.